John Chartier.
Here.
Mary Ann Dwyer. Bob Eichminger. Lisa Gavaluna. Kevin McCullough.
Here.
Diane Salter here. Dr. Outlaw.
Here.
Jan Mee.
Here.
And Christian Smith.
Hello.
Mackenzie Parsons.
Here.
Olivia Young. Everybody's here.
All right, thank you. Would everybody rise for the Pledge of Allegiance? Pledge of Allegiance.
To the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Okay, this evening we have our school showcase, which is the preschool.
Thank you. I'm Diane Dineen. I'm the director of preschool program and the director of special ed. Today I'm doing preschool. And I'm so thankful that we were able to have some children come today. We have Leo Malin. Leo, can you just raise your hand? All right. And Aria Goff.
Where's Aria? Raise your hand.
All right. And then Elizabeth Amy. Elizabeth? All right. And thanks, Mom and Dad, for bringing it today. To make the show. So I'm going to go through a little bit of, and you guys will see your pictures of them too, for the most part. Our preschool program, we primarily have four different preschool programs. We run three of them. Great Start Readiness Program is state funded. The Brandon Preschool Academy is tuition based. Head Start is a federally funded program that we allow OSHA to operate in our buildings. And then Early Childhood Special Education is included within our program. I give you a quick handout for those programs and pricing for next year. This is our preschool staff. We have teachers, we have associate teachers, and we have paraprofessionals and then early childhood specialists. All of our teachers are certified, teachers from the state of Michigan certified with early childhood endorsements. And then our associate teachers have to have either a certificate of development or they're teachers themselves or have an associate's degree. So highly educated teachers. And then our paraprofessionals are trained and all of them have to go through so much training as a part of our five-star rating through our program quality assessment. This is philosophy. We believe that all preschool is a solid base for all success in school and beyond. High school is the general curriculum that all of our preschool children use. And it's research-based. Staff, students, and parents desire integration of programs. So all of our children are integrated together, which includes benefits all children. And collaboration around parents, teachers, and specialists bring the quality program that we have. Our curriculum is high scope, research-based. KDI is the key development indicators, so that's like the benchmarks that would be in the other curriculums. And we use three different assessment tools, just like anybody else. We have the child observational records, ages and stages, and then a developmental profile for some students. Our big idea is that all play and work is child-initiated, so we provide the materials and they do with it as they choose. So it's open-ended, it's their creativity. Teachers and staff, they're the ones who have the open-ended questions. Tell me about it. What did you do? What is that? Okay, let them use language to bring that about. It's all student-driven by interest, and so we want to make sure we have enough interest there for students. The environment reflects home culture. So when we have families that their parents are in the medical field, we try to have medical things there, and they bring them in too for us. We have parents who have been in the military, so they'll bring in some military things to help and bring into our dress-up area, things that we can do. If we have parents who work in the food industry, they might bring in menus from their restaurants and things like that. So we're trying to bring in the home cultures into this classroom. We encourage students as opposed to, you know, praising. We want to increase their intrinsic motivation. We want them to be excited about what they're doing on their own. And it's all based on they plan something, they do it, and then we talk about it afterwards. To get a five-star rating, I told my staff, we have more requirements for preschool than we correctly do for special ed, which is sort of exciting, not really. We have the Michigan Department of Licensing and Regulations that we have to follow, go through. We have the rules of Great Start Readiness Program, which we use those high-quality rules for all of our programming. High school has a very intense expectation for their curriculum. The child observational records are very intense. There's about 200 different records that they have to record on every child every three times a year. And then the PQA, the Program Quality Assessment, which we get assessed three times a year, where outside early childhood specialists come in, they observe our staff engaging with students and how they interact with them to make sure that they meet the quality. This is not to be read, but primarily the key indicators are the approach of learning and initiating and planning and engagement, socialization and emotional development, cooperative play, we want them to work together. Conflict resolution is a big part of it, so that we're not always giving them the answers if there's a conflict, they handle it on their own. Physical growth and development, we are required to have at least 30 minutes of outside time as long as it's safe, you know, not too cold, and 30 minutes of growth motor development within the school day. And then, of course, language and literacy and communication, you'll see writing and books and reading going on throughout the whole day. So, I just have no pictures. So, you'll see a picture like this, and the students will use their stories and tell us about their stories. And we'll tell the teacher that, you know, that what did she draw? There's a rain cloud, the sun, and here's the house. That's her description of what she drew. All right? Other students will ask them, what did they do? And tell us about your picture. Not, what did, you know. I made a house, it had animals in it, I put the squares together to make it. Another thing, you know, teachers engaging with students the whole time, measuring and building in the sandbox, measuring with corn. So we're using math throughout the day, using cooperation throughout the day in our sensory area. Science is integrated throughout the day in small group and in our work area. Letters are disappearing from the hearts. It's a new thing where, you know, the conversation hearts. Put it in a certain substance and let it go away. Taking the magic, those are called magnet tiles. I call them magic tiles because they're really cool. I don't know how they fit together. Metal and magnets around the edges. And so because of our boards are magnets, they can use it there too. They can build with it, they can design shape with it, drawing and writing. Geometry starts at preschool. Made a train with a wall, it keeps the train from falling out. That's what Lena said. Teachers encourage students to help each other, so it's not just on their own. Dressing up like future work. What are we going to do when we grow up? Future architects. And they draw up big things and they tell you about them.
How much candy?
So what I'd like you guys to do, Leo, Aria, Elizabeth, if you guys could take some of your toys and maybe in between any of the board members, you take them to the tables and help them, show them what you're making, okay? And show them how to use them, all right? While I go through the rest of the pictures. Can you do that? We'll take some of the
time. Okay, here.
We have big siblings. You guys can help two siblings, okay? Sisters?
Show them over here. Show them what you can do. Show them the things. Show them the
up here, we also have computers in every room, and so they don't have a lot of time on it, but they do use some technology and start working with how to use the mouse. We have magnifying glasses to help with science. Reading and language goes on all day. Working together to show the missing layers. This is a picture of the Prometheus table that we found a couple years ago. So there's different things you can do with it.
Sure.
And you can just use the letters around to find the letters. We like to build things. Binoculars so they can look at things that are closer. And then racing in the gym. So when it's cold outside, you use the gyms or the moment room at Orlando. Remember the old spinning machines that you had and you fall off of them? Well, this is a spinner that you don't fall out of because it's got the sides. One of our playgrounds, and enjoying the snow outside, we go outside no matter what shot, but it is going to touch cold. Magnetiles. I don't know when they started making magnetiles, but they're definitely sort of new because I thought it was only 25 and I've never seen it before. Yeah. So keep that around 10 years.
There you go.
See? There's lots of things to build with.
That's hard to get them up
in the pool. Yeah, that's a big part.
You got the animals.
Yep. Look, she's got like the little.
She's going to build
the little room for them.
That's really nice.
We have a website. It's our Facebook page, Grand Early Childhood. And these are some quotes that parents send. Love every minute of my child growing up, reading and learning every day.
You want to help them make it bigger?
Dixon's are awesome. Yeah, they're teaching them and preparing them for big things. So these are just some quotes that parents share and put them on our Facebook. And share them with making friends. That's what it's about. And we want to thank you for your support because we really appreciate the board supporting all the preschool programs.
Thank you.
All the preschoolers and their siblings and parents for bringing them here tonight.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Now the problem is going to be when they try to take them away. Neil, can you help me clean up?
Decorations really took us to downtown Detroit because our theme was made in Detroit. And the DJ was amazing. Spirit Week brought a lot of energy and participation. We are having, we have like a challenge through each class. So right now the juniors are winning the competition for the Cedar Point trip. So at the end of the year, the class gets
like,
yeah, with the most spirit points gets to go to Cedar Point. So, and then juniors are in first, and then seniors are very close behind, and then sophomores and freshmen are in third and fourth place. Also, in student council, we have a blood drive coming up on March 9th, and we are conducting interviews for the student council members next year. For sports, the boys' varsity basketball team is 4-14, but each loss is only by a few points. This Friday, they have a game at Holly at 7:30, and the girls' varsity basketball team is 6-9, and they have a game as well on Friday at 6 at Holly too. The varsity Poms team plays 7th at their competition this past Sunday at MSU. Also, the boys and girls bowling team both have regionals on Friday and Saturday this weekend.
Link Crew had a successful challenge day. It changed a lot of students' perspective on the school and their peers. Right now, Link Crew is finishing up interviews for next year's leaders, and then they also just had the 8th graders at the high school for, they toured them. Well, they took them on a tour around the high school. The junior Link Crew members took them to like each class and explained what the classes were and what you could do like in our classes, and then they brought them to student council and explained that and stuff like that. And then the senior members helped the students pick out schedules. And then they also played games and music in the Ox Gym. And then the students left excited to start their high school careers next year. So.
That's about it going on right now.
Okay, so, yeah. Any questions?
Any questions?
No.
Thanks,
Nash.
Great job.
Thank you.
Okay.
Okay, thank you. Okay, I'm going to do something a little bit different over here. I'm going to walk through something on a website here, just so I can show everybody. As many of you know, we're going to be voting this evening on, board is going to be voting on a reorganization proposal. And I wanted to quickly go through the final document, just some of the things that are out there that are on the public website. If you went to our district website, if you've been there before on our quick links, we have a webpage that's been dedicated to district reorganization. It has all kinds of information on this page, but I'm going to show you to a couple things here. In the middle of the page, we have everything from letters to the community, the presentations, there's a screencast of our community forum, and there's a bunch of frequently asked questions, and then also a tally of questions that have been asked by community members over the past month and a half. I'm going to steer you to the Board of Education proposal, because this is specifically what the Board of Education has in front of them for this evening. This is on the website for the district. In this 47-page document, there's everything from a letter overviewing what the proposal is. There's details about the proposal, some of the additional details, specifics about start times and things like that, cost savings, so on and so forth. And I'm going to go through some of this very quickly. In this proposal, just as a summary for anybody that doesn't know, the reorganization calls for the closure of one building, Brandon Fletcher Intermediate School, and the high school. We would have a traditional high school, traditional middle school, 6 through 8, and then two traditional elementary schools with junior kindergarten through 5th grade. Preschool will primarily be at the Harvey Swanson preschool wing, where the preschool used to be in the past, and that's where the proposal's at. Fletcher would close, and during our work session today, we had a presentation by Plant Moran talking about selling some of the properties that that are unused. That's a conversation for another day, but we heard proposals about selling those buildings. Continuing forward, just to give you details of what's on here, this is something that many of you already have seen. It's on the website and several other spots, but here's some of the breakdowns of class sizes, the percentage of use in each one of the buildings, and kind of where each one will be, as well as our projected enrollment 5 years from now. Some of the additional details, these were some of the things that we needed at our last meeting, some of the things that were specific to the buildings. Start times, what those might look like. These could change depending on some things dealing with bus routes and things that we're looking into, but secondary pretty much stays the same. And at the elementary level, we are proposing moving them to the intermediate school time. That's actually great for a bus that takes about 15 minutes away for Oakwood and Harvey Swanson and their bus routes. But you can see there's a whole bunch of different things in there about sale of properties, when would we do staff reductions, April 17th, so on and so forth. We would like to do a traffic study, work with the police, the experts in that area to make sure that we have optimal traffic flow inside our lots and on the streets surrounding. But these are some additional details that may be of interest. Estimated cost savings. Again, this has been in all the documents, but this is with everything updated for Brandon Fletcher. The conservative numbers are at the top, the 8-12 number that we've been talking about. And then underneath that are other savings that are not as ironclad. For example, we know that we have savings by not having to do the bathrooms at Brandon Fletcher, but things like roofs, parking lots, and some of the unanticipated costs, those are things that are coming in the future that we can't solidify a number for you. So we're putting that in potential future savings. Those are ones that are certain, those are ones that are likely. One on here, for example, is transportation, where we have $100,000 as the placeholder in that area. When we get our transportation study, we believe that number will go up on what the savings will be, but we don't want to promise something that we can't deliver. So we're using a conservative number that we know that we can deliver. So those are some of the cost savings that we've been discussing. Other financial considerations. These are things on the left side that are not specific to reorganization. But as we reorganize, there's conversations that might talk about programming. We might want to look at some cosmetic things at Harvey Swanson. And these are things that the board in future discussions may choose to do, but these are not dependent on reorganization. On the right side, we talk about transition costs. By moving, are we going to pick up a lot of extra costs in transition? Some of the things that
We know we'll have some playground equipment moved. That'll be paid for out of the GSRP grant. We'll have to purchase boxes to put things in. That's minimal cost, but there will be boxes that will be purchased. We may have to have the Brandon Fletcher staff come in for an extra day during the summer to help do moves and whatnot so that we don't impede on the student instruction. That might cost, our estimate's $9,100. We put $10,000 just as a placeholder there. And then you know, we're going to do a study on route reconfiguration. But the costs are minimal that we have to have related to transportation. A lot of it will be done internally. But that's on there as well. Then project management timeline gives you an idea of month by month some of the different things that will happen. April, for example, is when we come to the board with staffing. March is when we complete that staffing process. May is when IEPs are done, so on and so forth. There's a little bit of an overview of the project management timeline. I have some maps on here of what this could look like. This depends on enrollment each year. This is Oakwood Elementary School. We actually use less rooms than what's on here, but this just shows what the capacity is and the rooms that are available. Harvey Swanson Elementary School, on the left side in the purple there is where the preschool classrooms would go. Theoretically, you could put the fifth grade in the area where the academy is today, and the other part of the building might be the same. But those are things that would be done in discussion with staff. This is the middle school. This just shows the purple is where the sixth grade would be in. This just gives you an idea of where they would be. This is an area, they're all kind of together here, special education room. Just gives you an idea of how it would be structured. The red is seventh grade. This is the second floor of the middle school. There's the eighth grade at the top, and then obviously in the red we have seventh grade. And then at the high school, in the red area, this is a special education area right next to the office. This just tells you kind of where the adult transition program might be located there. That's one of the spots. On the other side, there's another spot that's being considered as well. But just give you an idea of where people might be going. This is a list of frequently asked questions that you've been seeing, and it's been being updated. Additional questions, we had 96 people that submitted questions on our district website. Some of them were duplicate questions. So we made a running tally of what those questions are with responses to them. We've been answering these questions for a month and a half, but those are also on the website. It's everything from buses, costs, so on and so forth. Then, I'm just going to just do a couple of these, but then we have items to address by department. It's kind of a to-do list that each department has. For example, human resources. But here's dates when we have to do different things. When does staffing have to be done? When do the club advisors have to be done? This is a to-do list for Ms. Hamas and myself dealing with HR. Then we have special ed, preschool. Every single department has a to-do list that goes along with it that continues to grow. But if you wanted to know what are some of the transition things that need to be done, those are on there as well. So I appreciate you kind of bearing with me on that. I wanted to just take a moment and share that with you. So that's what we're doing tonight. Just wanted to run through the public document that is on that website. But thank you all very much. Appreciate it. Thanks for letting me do that.
Thank you. Okay, next item is public comments and questions on our agenda business. First thing is we're going to add action item F to our agenda, which is adding our firewall request for our IT group for $34,000. Glennis Hubbard, would you like to address the board?
Hi. It's been a long time since I've been up here. I would like to say thank you to Dr. Outlaw for the presentation. I did have a chance to look it over before I got here, and if anyone's been in the district long enough, probably 15 years ago, there was a big gripe about transparency and the board, and you really nailed it on the head, being able to lay it out there and say what you're doing, and as well as Mr. Stevens has done a nice job with transparency within the high school and the letters that have gone home, and thank you. But I am here to really talk about the reconfiguration and what you guys are doing with this in regards to the traffic. And I know it was mentioned that that's something that you're going to be looking at, but I didn't see really any questions posed by the public. And my assumption has to be that many of the people who are writing questions do not travel to the high school between 7:10 and 7:25 in the morning. I have done that since 2002. This is my third child. I am on my way out the door, but we still have traffic that needs to be considered as this move is made. When the middle school was built, where it was built, part of the consideration, part of the concern was what were we going to do as the district grew with the traffic in and out of the middle school. It really never got addressed. And now with TSC and spring coming, and TSC is very busy with contractors going north in the morning, and they ride that middle lane from the bank right up to TSC to make a left inside there. At the same time, you have cars traveling down the middle lane from Brandon Tire, and they ride that middle lane to make a left into the middle school. So if you're gonna add a whole nother grade to the middle school, you're gonna add what percentage, how many more cars? Even if it's 20, it's too many. The problem between, call it A&W and the mobile station during that time in the morning is awful. It's awful. It's an accident waiting to happen every single morning. And I'm asking the board to not only be proactive in this, but maybe involve the community if we need to make phone calls to MDOT. I know MDOT has done studies. I know there's not enough accidents. I know there's not enough deaths in that area. There's not enough traffic. Whatever it is, you guys are going to include MDOT in figuring what needs to be done in that traffic pattern. Nothing got done with the middle school when the middle school was built. And now we're going to be adding more people traveling that route into the middle school. And MDOT says there's no problem. There's going to be a problem. And something needs to be done again before we move into the fall. I know I had discussed with Mr. Stevens at a different meeting. Even standing, going to the dealership and standing up and looking at what happens at the middle school when people are turning, they're heading north, they're heading south, people are making a left off of Wolf Road, they're making a left and a right coming off of the car wash, and then getting in that middle lane and running over up into the middle school. At the same time, middle school parents are turning left out of there. That's just the parents. Then we have high school kids that are pulling left out of the high school. And I know, we addressed that, and it's something that Mr. Stevens and I had talked about that we would be doing, just taking a look at as we move forward. We have a couple of signs that I spoke with you about, Dr. Outlaw, and even Mr. Stevens, about speed zone signs during the busy time in the morning. Finally, I talked to Kathy Thurman was last fall. So we get two signs. Just last week, I found the second sign. So I'm going to talk to her about putting flashing lights up or doing something. But that sign really needs to be moved further south on M15 because now we have Genesis. And I heard there might even be a road coming in off of the Genesis Credit Union into the high school. I'm just asking that my point here tonight is that this is not just let's call MDOT and see what we can do, but to be strongly proactive and seeing that something can be done prior, a decision is made, and we can implement the routine prior to the new school year so that, again, we are proactive and we don't wait for something to happen. And that's all I got. Thank you.
Thank
good
you.
Luck with this.
Okay, any other public comments? Yes.
Good evening, I'm Dana DePalma. And first off, I just wanted to say that I appreciate appreciate you guys doing all of this for the reorganization, and I do feel bad for any staff or the school that has to close, but we need to do this now and not be in limbo for another year. To go off of the school bus issue, my major concern that's going to be worse is sixth graders on the bus with the high school. I know you said you're going to put them in the bus, oh, sixth graders in front, and so on and so forth, but you can't control the bus stop. The bus driver can't be watching the kids. The bus driver needs to be concentrating on driving. So a way to alleviate the traffic issue is to also make a separate bus route for high school, a separate bus route for middle school, and a separate bus route for the elementary schools. I know as a parent of a coming sixth grader, she will not ride the bus, and I know many who won't, so you will have a lot more traffic. So I know we might save money on transportation and all this, but maybe spend a little more to separate the different start times. Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else?
Hi, my name is Jennifer Mayo. I've been following all of the reconstruction closely. I was for what Ms. DePalma just spoke about and was told that was probably impossible to have three separate bus routes. But one thing I would ask you to consider at least is, I know that you talked, Dr. Outlaw just showed about the different start times and possibly having the elementary start time moved up a little bit earlier. But as it stands right now, we have school of choice students that aren't allowed to ride buses home. Now, in-district school of choice students. And for me, that was fine. You know, my daughter's in third grade, or she's in second grade now. Next year, she'll be in third grade, and I figured, well, that would be her last year. Well, now she's going to be in elementary school two more years, so I know I'm not the only person in that situation. So, from what I've been told before, we can't have three separate bus routes, but can we at least have transfer buses for the elementary school kids, since now we have the intermediate school space available, the time that the buses would be sitting at the intermediate school transferring students, can we at least have busing for all students home? And it would also cut down on the traffic up and down M15 if we didn't have so many parents, the in-district parents, picking up their kids from Oakwood and Harvey Swanson, which is really congested at this point. I'm sure most people agree. So just like to ask that. Thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else? Okay. Seeing and hearing none, we will move on with our agenda items. First thing is approval of our consent agenda. Do we have a motion?
Move that the Brandon Board of Education approve the consent agenda as presented.
Second. Okay. All those in favor of our consent agenda, please vote by saying yes.
Yes.
Yes. Any opposed? Okay, consent agenda passes. Information discussion items. Jan, anything you'd like to speak about?
I just wanted to bring you up to date on our high school security project, the never-ending project. A couple weeks ago, we were told that they made a change order. They needed to add to the project the ducts. There was no backup generators for the air ducts. That's the best I can explain it. So that would not pass inspection. We are they are finishing that right now, or they're working on that right now. It added $10,000 to the project. We are still, you know, using Danbur around the clock. So this project is probably going to end up being close to $150,000, which is, yeah, I know it's a lot. I'm hoping at this point, mid-March, because it takes a couple weeks, and then they have to call the inspector, and then they have to wait a week to get the final fire chief inspection done. So we're hoping mid-March at this point, which it was originally supposed to be done by Christmas.
Was the duct item because of an inspection, or how did
supposedly
that?
They didn't know about it until right at the end, and it sounds fishy to me. I got an email from John. John's in Florida now, right before the day he was leaving, and he was just told of it. So I said, well, we need a change order, and I you know, Mark Evans is now filling in for John in terms of the day-to-day looking, you know, the project management. But they, you know, it's been explained to me that they just didn't realize it, which I always find a little suspect because I feel like they should have known that when they quoted the project back in October. I don't know, John can explain this better than I'm explaining it, but so wanted to keep you up to date on that, and I did send a message to the company Simplex Grinnell and let them know that we really need this done like ASAP. Time is of the essence. We're paying round the clock security, and you know, trying to push them a little bit. I haven't been working with them on a regular basis because that was more John that was working with them.
When's John back from Florida?
Mid-March. So we signed, Dr. Outlaw signed the change order. We got the company going, kind of kicked it around a little bit. Mark brought in another, our local electrician to see if they could do it cheaper. It just, it wasn't going to work. This is a company that's been working the project the whole time. So, I wish I had a better explanation why it's taking so long. It really shouldn't. I know they're working at night, but they knew that they were going to do that from the beginning. So hopefully by next meeting, I can tell you the project's done.
Do we have any holdback money on that?
John always, yes, he does. Yes, definitely. We keep a portion back. Exactly what the payment schedule's been, I would have to, I didn't look that up before I came, but we always withhold a large portion of any capital outlay or any capital project.
Right.
I know. We got our bid. Simplex now is a good company.
Sure, not questioning that as much as just the basis for the realization at this point in time.
And usually it's bad enough when a project goes so long, but now we're paying this extra thing, which makes this project really tough.
Okay, so I apologize if I need my memory refreshed. What documentation do we have governing this relationship? What's in play?
Contract.
We have a contract. Can I see that contract?
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Yeah. We'll get it to you tomorrow.
Thank you.
Yes.
Does the whole board want to see it then? You should, yeah.
I'll trust Lisa.
Okay.
I trust Lisa.
Okay.
What's the holdup on the time frame? Is it because of inspections or is it because
Because they have this change order. They realized that they were not going to pass inspection because of the air duct problem.
Okay.
So they went back to, or they
now
came
who
to
said that was it? Was it the inspector or was it them?
I believe it was the actual company, Simplex Grinnell.
Okay. Was it in, so that air duct wasn't in their original bid when they put that in?
Correct. Because they were set to come in on a Friday, like two Fridays ago. Wednesday was John's last day. On a Thursday, the day before the inspectors were set to come in, is when we got notice that there was a problem. So the inspection was canceled and everything, and then they re-quoted or they sent a quote over for the change order.
Well, probably the first thing I would check and make sure and ask the inspector, would it pass with or without it?
It would not have passed. No, absolutely not. No.
Didn't they do a pre-inspection?
It could have been the pre-inspection.
They did a pre-inspection. They found a number of things that were not going to fly during inspection, and this was one of them. This was the one that cost us money, but that's why it's taking so long. That's as I understand it from John. It's taking a long time.
I'm suspicious. It sounds like they were negligent on their part. They didn't know really what they were getting into.
Just, again, sorry for all the questions to you, because I know you're kind of doing the best you can to put it all together. But we were supposed to be done by December?
The original target date was it would be completed by Christmas or sometime over the Christmas break.
And they're attributing the delay to this?
No,
this is
an added delay. But even without this delay, we were looking at mid-February. Maybe
what are they attributing the delay to otherwise?
That's a great question, because I haven't, you know, and I haven't been one-on-one, and I, you know, with them.
Sure.
I would question John, what's going on? Why are we getting, you know? And I wasn't getting a great answer, but it was the project was taking longer. Okay, well, we can ask more questions. I'll send you the contract.
Okay.
Yeah.
That would be great.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Whole final payment as well.
Not happy. Thank you.
Any other good news?
Sorry. The state might give us $100.
I hope the state gives $100. I always hope the state gives $100.
It's always right there.
Well, at least the governor's talking the right words. We'll see what the other branches do.
Better than silence.
Right, yeah.
I said a thought about the fire project. We could actually use our capital projects money, but never mind.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Thank you.
Yep. Ms. Spann?
Just to recap what we discussed in the workshop earlier this evening, there are three proposals that are before you shortly. One is to approve the Sex Education Advisory Board timeline. Last month, you gave the go-ahead to convene a Sex Education Advisory Board. And then this timeline lays out the process as it would play out, starting with a survey to families that would go out tomorrow, the opportunity to apply to be on the board. The board would consist of 13 voting voices, comprised of 50% parents. Of the parents, at least 50% will not be employed by a school district. We'll have two teachers on the board, three students, but ultimately one of the 13 voting people. They'll meet right now, tentatively. We've had it set up to meet three times. And then we would come to you in May with a recommendation for whatever the board wants to put forward. So we would have a public hearing. We would have another public hearing on June 19th. We would revisit that recommendation, answer questions, and then you would vote as to whether or not you would like to accept that recommendation from the board or not, from the Sex Education Advisory Board. So tonight, the issue is just to approve the process that's been laid out, and want to make sure that you are kept informed all the way along just what we're doing and how we're going about it, transparency. Also before you are the proposed adoptions of two courses at the high school, both of them semester-long courses, so that we can add to the elective opportunities for our high school students, one in the science department, one in the math department. In science, the state requires that we have that students have three full years of science to graduate. Biology is a requirement, and they have to have physics or chemistry. And the state says, or agricultural science, or anyway, this gives students, the anatomy physiology proposal gives students the opportunity to select an additional elective that would be very hands-on and lays a nice foundation for anybody who's interested in the medical field in particular. The other course is from the math department. There's a requirement that students have 4 credits of math to graduate, 2 in algebra, 1 in geometry. That leaves a full credit left for electives. And offering sports statistics would expand their elective opportunity. We already offer a statistics class, but for many people, statistics can be a little bit dry. For the many people who are involved in sports, have some interest in sports, this would provide an opportunity to study statistics using content that is already interesting and provides a nice hook for them to make sense of all the statistical analyses. So those are the two courses. We wouldn't require anybody to be additionally trained. The staff that we already employ have the certifications necessary to teach these courses. Financially, we've already looked into making sure that we have the money to cover the cost of the books and startup fees. So we're all set there.
But the motion as it's stated tonight is to approve the courses,
only,
not to spend any money.
Correct.
So
we're just approving the courses, and I will come to you next month with a request for the textbooks.
Understood. Got it. Anything else, Ms. Spann?
Not unless you have questions for me.
Any questions? Okay. Moving on to the action items. First action item on our agenda this evening is the approval of the reorganization proposal for the 2017-2018 school year. Do we have a motion?
Move that the Brandon Board of Education approve the reorganization proposed for the 2017-2018 school year as presented.
Second.
Okay, we've had a short presentation this evening by Dr. Elwah. We talked about this in the work session beforehand. We've had several meetings and communication regarding this, which proposal before us is to close the intermediate school and consolidate as we discussed. Are there any further discussions, points, or questions, or comments, or anything else that we want to have?
Sorry, I did not hear who supported
Diane.
Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't.
Anything? Anyone? Okay. All those in favor of approving the reorganization proposal for the 2017-2018 school year as presented, please vote by saying yes.
Yes.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Item 2, adoption of revised policy 0167.3, public participation at board meetings. Do a motion.
Move the Brandon Board of Education adopt revised policy 0167.3, public participation at board meetings as presented.
Second.
Okay. And this is when we talked about essentially what we would not restrict anyone from speaking at our meetings, which is the policy that we actually follow today. Okay. All those in favor of supporting this policy adoption, please vote by saying yes.
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 Any opposed? Okay, motion approves. Third item, approval of the Plant Moran proposal for the annual audit.
Move that the Brandon Board of Education approve the Plant Moran proposal for the annual audit as presented.
Okay. And this is just for our annual financial audit
this
that we
is
do
an
every
extension.
Year.
Yes, it's a three-year extension track.
Okay. All those in favor of approving Plant Moran's proposal for the annual audit, please vote by saying yes.
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 Any opposed? Okay. Item D, approval of the Sex Education Advisory Board proposal, which deals with the forming of the panel and the schedule that was discussed prior. Motion?
The Brandon Board of Education approves the Sex Education Advisory Board process and the makeup of the Sex Education Advisory Board as presented.
Support.
Okay. Any discussion on this? Ms. Spann here kind of wrapped it up a few minutes ago what we're doing. Okay, all those in favor of approving the Sex Education Advisory Board process and the makeup of the Sex Education Advisory Board as presented, please vote by saying yes.
Yes.
Yes. Any opposed?
No.
Okay. Motion carries. Approval of new high school courses, anatomy, physiology, and sports statistics.
Move that the Brandon Board of Education approve new high school courses, anatomy, physiology, and sports statistics as presented.
Second. And again, Spann outlined what these courses are. This would approve setting up the courses. It does not approve any costs or materials or books, which she would bring to us at a later point in time. All those in favor of approving the new high school courses, anatomy, physiology, and sports statistics as presented, please vote by saying yes.
Yes.
Yes. Any opposed? Okay. And item F that we added, which was the firewall request for our IT department here for $34,000. We get a motion for that.
Move the Board of Education approve the expenditure of $34,000 for the expanded firewall expense.
Second.
And as Jan outlined before, we were looking to get reimbursed essentially for 70% of that, but we're still waiting for that decision.
Yeah, we applied last summer for that reimbursement,
right.
Last spring actually.
So if we get our approval, our cost would be approximately $9,000. Worst case is a $34,000 that we're approving this evening.
I have a question.
Yes.
Is there any chance it would be above 34? So for purposes of this approval, we need to have a not exceeding?
I had an informal quote on Friday. We were going back and forth. Did not expect this to come to the board tonight. Like I said, this was an emergency over the weekend. I guess there's always a chance, but that's what the email, I wanted to get a ballpark, like what are we looking at,
okay.
From the company. I was involved in the email chain with them. But at that time, it was like when the E-rate funding comes in.
Sure.
He said 33,888.
Okay.
So
I just didn't know if there was a little bit of wiggle room, so we're giving
not
what's
really
needed to move forward.
Yeah.
Oh. We'll do the best we can with 34 then.
Okay.
We'll revisit if we have to.
If something changes, we'll come back.
Okay, all right, just want to give everybody needs.
Any question, any further discussion on that? All those who approve, all those in favor of approving the expenditure of $34,000 for the firewall request for IT, please vote by saying yes.
Yes.
Any opposed? Okay. And last item this evening is citizens' input. Does anyone wish to address the board? Hearing and seeing none, our meeting is adjourned. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.